So phylogenomic studies are consistently showing us a great deal of variation in gene tree topologies and how these heterogeneity can be, in the case of systematic error, can really be a problem for species tree sequence. So we learned that just by adding more and more sequence data, it's not going to be a good enough solution to solve the most difficult nodes in the tree of life. That's why we're seeing a great efforts to improve methods and improve models, and also into understanding what's the best type of data that we should be using to carry out these inferences. And that's a little bit of what I'm going to be talking about. So some of these most difficult nodes are those characterized by ancient and rapid radiations. And as an illustration of those, I'll show an example of the gymnotiforms, which are a clade of neotropical freshwater fish that radiated about 100 million years ago. And what's coolest about these fish is that they are electric, so they can produce and detect an electric field around their bodies. And some families have produced signals that are pulses, and some families produce signals that are in the shape of waves. However, so far, no phylogenetic study have been able to provide a robust hypothesis of how these families are related, and therefore how these complex electrocommunication systems happen. And because of the characteristics of which are conserved elements, we thought that it could be a good type of marker to infer these deep relationships. And we threw in about 1,000 of these loci concatenation, and hey, we thought could be very happy because we got a fully supported tree, but you don't have to look very closely to see how short these deep internodes are. And this is a common problem in this type of radiations, where not only there's very little information to infer these relationships, but also this information can be obscured by the noise or homophily that could have been accumulated post-divergence along these pretty long branches. In fact, when we try to do a karyotype species tree, for example, here I'm showing astral, which we see very little support for the deeper splits or support for different topologies. So are these inconsistencies due to the different methods or the different type of data that we're using? So I decided to compare different data filtering strategies. Some of them that I used have been commonly used in the literature. I also use another approach, which I call target filtering, because I'm going to be looking at loci that particularly affect some of the nodes that I'm interested in my tree. In this case, I'm interested in the origin of the gymnotiforms. So then I selected a fraction of the loci that had higher phylogenetic informativeness for that specific region of the tree. However, phylogenetic informativeness doesn't take into account homoplasy. So then on top of that, I calculated the probability of these loci to resolve the polytomy, just taking into account the phylogenetic signal and not the noise. So I redid all my analysis, and I didn't observe any changes in support topology for the concatenated stuff. But then I got an increase in support for all my species tree, the highest support for when taking into account phylogenetic signal over noise. I also observed an increase in gene tree congruency here, represented, for example, by the frequency of gene trees that recover my family's as monophyletic, and also improved convergence and performance of some computationally intensive methods, such as StarBase, where we obtain with high confidence a species tree, which is the same topology that we're getting in Astral, where for the first time we're recovering the pulse type families and the waveform type families as reciprocally monophyletic with considerably high support. As a conclusion, I could say that filtering strategies in general and target filtering in particular could be a good tool to both reduce gene tree disagreement and increase support in our species tree, although these type of strategies can highly depend on the type of phylogenetic inference methods that we're using. And thank you very much.